Good morning. I welcome you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Today is our fifth Sunday after February. At this time, want to enjoy us, maybe you at home or in the church, to please let us sing from Voices United, number 766, as the deer pant after my soul, and that is verse 1. And please be seated as we listen to the announcement this morning.
Good morning, everyone. You can read the announcements in your bulletin. I'm just going to highlight on a few. Wednesday night, there's quilting at 1 o'clock. Guides at 6:30 to 7:45, and girls at 9 to 11. Choir practice will be at 7:15 on Wednesday. And they're having Bible study every Wednesday night, or Wednesday actually, from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m., and then again at 6 p.m. to 7. Youth with a Purpose is on Wednesdays as well. It's from 6 to 7. So you can read the rest of the announcements in the bulletin when you get the chance. Thanks.
Let me also invite everyone here to our monthly praise and dance every second Sunday of every month. It's going to be 4:30, we'll start with potluck, and 5, we'll gather in this church, in this sanctuary, to praise God and to dance and to pray together. Are you ready to shake your body? So prepare yourself. Every second Sunday of every month, 4:30 in the afternoon, we gather for potluck. Then 5 o'clock, we'll all move here. And you are ready to shake your head and to dance. Just prepare that. And also, I will also relate to us that we have an employment opportunity for the church. The church is looking for administrative secretary to join our dynamic and flexible team at this church. And it's between 20 to 30 hours per week, and the pay commensurate with experience. We need somebody with office computer skill and light bookkeeping. The person should send his or her resume to St. James. The email is there, and you can call the church office for any other inquiry. Yeah, I think that is that for now. We have so many donations this morning, I will ask you to read that. Let me use this time to welcome some of our guests who are worshiping with us this morning. One of our parents are here this morning from Nigeria, Baba and Mama Awuniyi. They are sitting at the back. Thank you for coming. And we have our brother also, Brother Awuniyi, who is the son of Baba and Mama. He is also worshiping with us. Thank you for joining us this morning. We also have two of our friends, family friends, who are visiting with us from United Kingdom. They have been with us since, when was that? Friday morning. And they will be here with us for some few weeks. Rio and Esther, you are welcome. God bless you. And those other faces that I may not know, I will be glad to meet you after the church at our coffee and tea time at the conference, the boardroom here. Just, I would like to shake your hands and exchange greetings with you. If there are any other announcement, I will be passing it to us during the service. The Lord is in this house. Brethren, let us take the call to worship together from our bulletin, and it is from Psalm 121 and verse 1. Praise the Lord. Blessed are those who fear the Lord, who find great delight in his commands. Let us pray. Thank you, Jesus, this morning because you are God. Thank you because in your presence there is fullness of joy. Thank you for bringing us together to fill us, to equip us, to challenge us, and to send us forth as your children. Lord, as we gather in this house, we pray today that your Holy Spirit and power will rest upon us. I pray for everyone here and those that are watching us online, that your Spirit will rest upon us. I pray that your presence will be made visible in our life. As you did in that upper room in the books of Acts, you released a Holy Ghost upon them, and there were manifestation of your gift and your Spirit. I pray that there will be manifestation of your gift amidst us today, in the name of Jesus. Even in our prayers, in your word, in our song, I pray that life will be transformed. There will be deliverance. There will be freedom. There will be salvation. And at the end of today's service, every one of us will have full cause to glorify your name. This and many more we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. I can hear your amen. Amen.
Amen.
That is too shallow. Amen.
Amen.
That is good. Thank you for that. And our first hymn is printed in our bulletin, Be Still for the Presence. And please, as you are able, you may stand. This is celebrations time. If you have anything to celebrate this morning and you like to share with the church, maybe you have an anniversary, a birthday, any Thanksgiving, and you want to thank God for this cold, for this snow. Yeah, okay.
We
23 and a surprise visit from for the weekend. The house was full. Congratulations. Any celebrations? Nigel, happy birthday to you. Where's the cake? Okay. Any other celebrations? Okay, let's sing happy birthday. I think that will be good. Okay, let's sing together. Happy birthday to you. Jesus be praised, may God's richest blessings abide unto you. And our next hymn is from Voices United. This is it pink or red or this book? Yeah, Voices United number 352. I danced in the morning. And please dance. Shake your body. 3, 5, 2. I want us to put it into practice now. We are not practicalizing it. It is dance, dance. We are standing. Oh, yeah? Let's sing it, the chorus one more time. And I want you to dance. One, two, okay. Yeah.
Where you may be, I am the Lord of the dance, and I lead you on. Wherever you may be, and I lead you on in the dance.
One more time.
I dance there, wherever you may be. Oh, I am the Lord of the dance, and I lead you on. Wherever you may be, and I lead you on in the dance.
Wow. Let us clap our hands for Jesus. Yeah. Who was the best dancer this morning? Fran, you have a cup of tea after the service. Okay. And with that, let me invite Temilade for Bible reading this morning.
Good morning, everyone. Today, I am reading to you from the book of Matthew, chapter 5, 13 to 20. You are the salt of the earth, but if the salt loses its flavor, how shall it be seasoned? It is then good for nothing but to be thrown and trampled underfoot by men. You are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden, nor do they light a lamp and put it in a basket, but on a lampstand, and it gives light to all who are in the house. Let your light shine before men, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. Do not think that I came to destroy the law or the prophets. I did not come to destroy, but to fulfill. For assuredly, I say to you, till heaven and earth pass away, one jot or one tittle will by no means pass from the law till all is fulfilled. Whoever therefore breaks one of the least of these commands, and the teacher shall be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does and teaches them, he shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I say to you that unless your righteousness exceeds the righteousness of the scribes and Pharisees, you will by no means enter the kingdom of heaven. This is the word of the Lord.
Jesus, your Savior.
wordings of the song says what brings us together, what joins our heart, is Jesus Christ our Savior, and with him we are one. With that, let us pray. Speak to us, dear Jesus, today through your word. I pray that the entrance of your word will give us light. I pray that your word today will give us freedom. I pray that your word this morning will work salvation. I pray that your word today will take us to know more, to see you, and to dwell in your presence all the days of our life. Holy Spirit, speak to us. Speak to us. The book of Genesis says, in the beginning, the Lord made heaven and earth. We pray that you made yourself visible in our life through your word this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Oh my God, that is too low. Amen. Yeah, that is better. Sometimes ago, I cook a food in the house. I put everything, but I forgot something. And when my children, they had that food, they said, Daddy, you didn't put salt. And to me, it wasn't intentional. I forgot. Not once, not twice, but they were detected. I didn't know, maybe you have been in my shoes before. Maybe you have cooked food or had any food. Everything was good. The oil, the curry, the what other things? All the condiments were there. But you forgot the salt. Can you tell me how it tastes? Tasteless? That is one. I want you to talk to me, please. George, talk to me. Huh? Blind. Okay. Somebody want to say something here? Not spicy enough. Okay. Sometimes ago, one of our friends was in one country, and I was talking to him. He said, there is no light. I've forgotten that I'm, he told me that there was no light. I told him that, what do you mean? No light? He said, I have no light. I've forgotten that, that was the reality. To some of us in Canada, in some part of the world, we might not know that. Yeah, but in some parts of the world, in the night, it is always very, very dark. So this morning, I'll be talking to us about what is Christian character. And I'll be speaking to us from Matthew chapter 5, verses 13 to 20. And Jesus was using two very spectacular day-to-day encounters, experience, to narrate and to tell his disciples, not everybody, his disciples, what he was expecting from us to be our character. I want you to know that Jesus was just talking to his disciple after Matthew chapter 5 verses 1 to 12. And he talked to them about blessed are those who are mourning, blessed are those who are peacemakers. Yeah, then he moved now to Matthew chapter 5, verses 13. After the Beatitude. So this morning I'll be speaking to us on Christian characters. Yeah, give me the first. The first century church, the one that Jesus started, turned their world upside down. They set their world on fire. But today, what is happening? Today's church, we are more larger than the first century church. We have resources, we have technology, we have everything. But today, the world is turning the church upside down. The world is dictating what the church is doing. The world is setting examples for what the church ought to do. And in fact, the Christians, we are blended with the world. There is no more separation. Today, the first question I would like to ask us is, why are we not setting the world on fire again? Why? 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 It is because we need a character revival and reawakening. Then I look up at the dictionary. What is character? A character can be defined as collection of personality traits within our behavior that shows who we are. Integrity, attitude, moral fiber, disposition, and how we treat those around us. And what is Christian characters? Christian character describes who we are as Christian and what we are called to be. Not any other thing. What we are called to be as Christian. That is our character. In the passage read to us this morning, in Matthew chapter 5, exactly verse 13, Jesus likened his disciples to salt. And in 13a, he said, you are the salt of what? Oh, my church, you are not talking to me. You are the salt of what? Jesus was not telling his disciples, you used to be salt of the heart. Was that the tense? It is what? Present, you are. Continue. Now, you are. Not you was, you were. No. You are the salt. In ancient times, salt was a valuable commodity used to preserve food and add flavor. I want you to notice the present tense as Jesus tells his disciples, they are salt and light. Now, not in some distant future or in the past. Jesus is telling his disciples that just as salt adds flavor and preserve, Christians should add flavor, preserve, and light the world with our good works and positive influence. When you look at salt benefits and uses, you begin to understand why Jesus was telling his disciples, you are the salt of the earth. And don't forget, I told you, I cook food. I didn't add what? Huh? Don't forget that. Number one quality of salt is that salt had flavor. The next one. Salt does what? It adds flavor. What does that mean? Salt brings out the potential in food and qualities that already exist. It makes beef to take what? Huh? It makes beef to take like beef. And when you are cooking soup, maybe rice or anything, it makes it to what? To taste like rice. If you are cooking potato, it makes it to taste like potato. If you are cooking sauce or soup, it makes it to taste like what? Like soup. So salt is very, very important. It brings out the potentials. It seasons. What does that mean? As Christians, disciples of Christ, we have a seasoning influence. Look at me. It is not... Disciple means somebody who is ready to follow his what? His master. The person that have said, it is you that I want to follow. It is somebody who is singing this song that I'm about to sing. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. No turning. Not somebody who said yes and at the back is doing some other things. Not somebody on Sunday that put on the pastoral cloth like me and on Monday is somebody else. Not somebody who preached something at the church and who is not following it. Not somebody who is pretending to be Christian. And disciple of Christ have a seasoning influence. Do you season others? When others see you, do they know you are a Christian? Number two, salt preserves. It doesn't allow things to get spoiled. I remember when I used to be in our village. Don't mind me, I'm a village boy. And when we went for hunting, and we catch some fish, it was very dark in the evening, and no fridge. It was too late to make fire. You can smoke it, you can dry it. So my brother said, let us put hard salt. We added salt. And very early in the morning, when we make some firewood, we put the fish on what? On that fire. The fish was as fresh as if it was just caught at that time. Salt preserves. It never allowed things to get spoiled. Disciple of Christ have to preserve. And what are we preserving? Today, what do you preserve? We are to preserve the integrity of our faith. We are to preserve the teachings of the Word of God. We are to let people know that this is what is right and this is what is wrong. But today, are they not the one who is telling us this is right and this is wrong? No wonder we need character revival and reawakening. The disciples of Jesus are called to assist for others. And in verses 13b, it says, if the salt loses what? Oh, my church, you are not talking to me. Loses what? Its saltiness. How can it be made salty again? Is there any way that the salt can be restored when it lost its saltiness? No way. There is no way to restore the salt to the true and natural state. And once it has lost its flavor, salt is what? Salt is what? It's good for nothing. And will be what? Discarded and trampled underfoot. What does that mean? That salt is useless. It's wasteless. Doesn't good for anything again. It says Jesus was talking about salt, but actually he was talking to his disciples. And today we can apply this word of Jesus to our lives. Are we salt? Do we season? Do we preserve? There is a remedy, and there is a way out. If it doesn't season, if we are not preserving, the Bible is telling us we have lost our flavor. We have lost what? Our natural state. The Bible is telling us that the salt is good for nothing and it will be discarded. I pray it will not be good for nothing, will not be discarded in the name of Jesus. There is a way out. Let's look at the second one. Chapter 5, verse 14. I've told us that in this, in maybe in Canada or some parts of the world, of North America or South, yeah, we might not actually know that they may take light for a day, 2 days, or 3 days. Sometimes they want to take light for, because it was windy, they want to take light for maybe 5 hours. They were announcing it. I said, eh? And they told us that so time, they will restore it, and they restore it. In some part of the world, for 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, even a year, no light. 5:14. Jesus said, you are the light of the world. You are what? Jesus calls us the light of the world. The Christian is like a city set on a hill. It is elevated above its surroundings and shines. I miss what? I miss darkness. That is the work of light. To shine, I miss what? I miss where there is no darkness, there is no need for what? There's no need for light. But do I tell you there is darkness in the world? Every day, people are killing themselves. People are committing suicide. Marriages are being broken. Children are leaving their families. This and that are happening. We had the light. They are to see you, see your family, see your life, see how you act, see how you behave, see how you talk. I said, huh? This is what? This is a Christian. Look, the first Christian, they were not known because of anything. They are known because they were behaving like whom? Oh, you are not talking to me, church. They are behaving like what? Like Christ. That is what they call them, Christian. It was a very sorrowful language then. That look at them. They are Christian. They are following Christ. They are Momo. Do you know what they call Momo? Ogo. They call them Ogo. Because they are following Christian. They are behaving like Christ. What does Ogo mean? Huh? What is Ogo? Huh? Talk to me. Tell me the meaning now. Somebody who is not wise. Somebody who is not wise. They are not wise for Jesus. They don't claim their right. They were there to affect others, to touch lives, to do things for the kingdom. People are talking about them at the back. They don't care. They say, I don't care. As far as heaven is what? Is my goal. My purpose is to follow Jesus. My purpose is to, my God. They become the light. And today, what started with only one, then later three, then later 12, is now what? Throughout the whole world. I must even tell you that even in the Islamic, chronic Islamic country, we have Christians there. Even in chronic communist country, we have Christians there. Why? It's because some people were what? Were a town built on a hill that cannot what? That cannot be hidden. The question for you and me this morning is, are you and me a light that cannot be hidden? Look, you have to answer that question yourself. I'm not to answer that question for you. Verse 15 says, neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let's read verse 16 together. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, go. In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and do what? And glorify your Father. Let me round it up this morning. I think I've talked. This passage is a wake-up call to every one of us this morning. Maybe you are old or young. Maybe you are new as a Christian. Or maybe you are old as a Christian. It doesn't matter our age in Christ. This is a wake-up to us this morning to make an effort to affect the world around us with the help of what? Of the Holy Spirit. It is not by your power. It is the Holy Spirit that can help you. Do you know, many are times we want to do, but we are not able. But when we ask, Holy Spirit, help me, He takes charge. And this flesh will be what? Will be succeeded. Christians should not blend in with everyone else. Instead, we should affect others positively. Just as seasoning brings out the best in food, and light glows at night and can be seen for miles. Therefore, this morning, my church, St. James United Church, I have a charge to every one of you. I have, after this service, what I want you to do, the life that I want you to live, the actions that I want you to take. I want you to live out in public what you are. And you are what? You are not talking to me. I want you to live out in public what you are. You are what? Live out that light. Let people see you. Let people, so you are a Christian? Yes, tell them you are a Christian. Sometimes ago, we were at the superstore putting the tracks on people's car. And we done it. And we'll stamp it with St. James United Church. There was this Bible college over there, some New Brunswick University, and the man invited me and said, Reverend Ben, I saw a tract on my car, and I saw St. James United Church. You do evangelism in your church? I said, we do. He was asking me some questions. Do you believe in Jesus Christ? I said, why am I here? If I don't believe in Jesus, Jesus Christ made me to be here. Live out what you have, light. Attract people to God. Shine the deeds of Christ so others are impressed by what God is doing. And the word good here, it means Kalos. It means something that you do that attract others. Live so that others see your life. Hear your word, observe your works, and give glory to God. And listen to this. The joy of lives in which Christ is seen speak louder than the persuasion of words. When people see you, how you live out Christ-like, they receive joy. Rather than saying, I'm a Christian, what do they see? They didn't see anything. Instead, they know you to be what? To be temperament. They know you that you cannot welcome others. They know you that nobody can move closer to you. They know you for who you are. Even when somebody hear that you are going to that church, they will run away. Are you sending people out of the church or you are bringing them in? The joy of lives in which Christ is seen speaks louder than the persuasion of words. People want to see what you say in you. Your children want to see what you are saying. They want to know what you believe. They will see it in you, and that's why they will follow you to the church. Live it out. Let them see it. Enough is enough. Abby? Okay, let's go out with these questions. Three questions. Number one, I want you to ponder on this question. I'm not asking you for an answer now. The first one, who does your friend and community think you are? Do they think you're a Christian? Do they think you are part of them? Do they see any differences? Number two, do they see Christ when they see you? Do they see Christ When they see you, then number three, do you make it a point to season intentionally and shine for Jesus? Let us pray. I don't know, maybe God is talking to you this morning, but I want you to use this time to speak to God. If there's any way you have not been showing a Christian character and you are in this church this morning, or you are watching me online, this is a challenge to you. Ask God, come into my life, change me. Holy Spirit, help me, I cannot do it myself. Paul said, I want to do it, but the flesh doesn't allow me. What I want, the good that I want to do, I cannot do it because of Mr. Flesh. Ask Holy Spirit, take control of my life. I think you are praying this morning. Come on, pray, don't play. Pray, don't play. Pray, don't play. Ask Holy Spirit to help you. Ask God to take control of your life, to change you in and out, both the preacher and my church member. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Your word is two-edged sword, sharper, and is able to pierce into the hearts. I don't know, Lord, this morning, but I know you're about to do something in our life. Therefore, Lord, we have heard your word. Our heart is gripped. I pray that what you have started, you continue to do it. And what you have planned to do through your word this morning, you will be able to accomplish it. Touch the life of your children. May we become the salt and the light that you have called us to be. This and many more we ask in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Thank you very much. It is time for mission and service, and this morning we'll be sharing with the church the church scholarship to Woodstock High School. This is my fourth year. Okay, I'm starting my fourth year now. But from year 1, 2, 3, I've discovered that every year, certain amount of money is given out to the school, Woodstock High School, as a scholarship donation. So I want to invite, is it Peter or John, to speak on it this morning? John is here. Yeah, we need to know how we are spending our money and what this is for. Last week we talked about the Children Health Fund, and Dr. Keith told us that in this town and beyond, doctors, pharmacists, and co. are sending their bills, maybe for those who cannot pay, and the church is taking care of it. This is one way that we are spending this money. This is another one. Next week, we'll be hearing another one. Thank you, John.
Thank you. I did find out a bit about why we did the scholarship, and at one time, it was on behalf of Mary Green's dad. And since that, I guess, it just came on the agenda for the Board of Stewards, and we approved it. So what we really need to do is rethink why and talk about it at the annual meeting. Okay? Thank you.
What touched me is that this scholarship touched somebody's life, a life of one somebody, somewhere. It helps, it transforms one life. It encourages somebody to further his or her education. It touches someone's life, and that is the importance. And with that, this morning, I want to encourage our church members to let us give generously. I know you have been given, and maybe you have not been given. You are thinking how the money is spent. Yeah, we are spending it judiciously. Next week, coming week, we are still going to hear some other ways in which we are spending. Every week in the month of February, we'll be hearing how we spend the money. So I want to encourage us to give and give and give as the Lord is blessing us. In our family, as your minister, I'm not only asking you to give while myself I'm not giving. The 10% of our income goes directly to the church every month. No, sorry, every 2 weeks. No matter any expenditure, we first remove that 10%. So I want to challenge you. Maybe you may want to give more than 10%. Maybe you want to give, yeah, but I want you to challenge you. You see, when you give to Christ. You are showing Christ what? Christ's character. So we have our offering box at the entrance of the church this morning. If you want to give, you can put your offering at the box. And at the end of the year, you'll be given a charity receipt to file your tax at the end. Not only you are giving, but you are also receiving back. You give and charity receipt will be given to you to file your tax at the end of the year. And you're also following the injunctions of Christ. Not only that, you can give by PA. What is PA? PA means pre-authorized remission. That is, they will just set you up and you give monthly, whatever you can give. They will just deduct it from your salary. Talk to the church office and you'll be set up. Not only that, you can give on the church website, there's a donate button. Go to that button, click on it, very easy. And I pray as we are giving, the Lord will bless us in the name of Jesus. I want to invite us to let us stand this morning as we take the offertory prayer. Let us stand together and take the offertory prayer. Let us pray. Dear Jesus, your love makes us salt for the heart and light for the world. Bless our gifts so that they bring light into days and salt to new with your justice and mercy. Amen. And please let us take Voices United and open to page 918 as we say the new creed together. Page 918 in our Voices United. Let us let us affirm our faith in the words of the new creed from page 918. Page 918. Somebody is telling me, wait for me. I'm waiting for you. Yeah. Are you there? Okay, let's go together. We are not alone. We live in God's word. We believe in God, who has created and is creating, who has come in Jesus, the word made flesh, to reconcile and make new, who works in us and others by the Spirit. We trust in God. We are called to build the church, to celebrate God's presence, to live with respect in creation, to love and serve others, to seek justice and resist evil, to proclaim Jesus crucified and risen, our judge and our hope, in life, in death, in life beyond death. God is with us. We are not alone. Thanks be to God. Amen. And please be seated. The Spirit of God moved through voice and shadows. As humans were created, the air of God filled the lungs of Adam and soul of Eve. On this first Sunday in the second month, we celebrate this, the coming of the Holy Spirit on the disciples, and invite the Holy Spirit to fill us anew. Pour out your Spirit to make the elements come alive for us. May we begin to celebrate visions and animate the dreams that have only been alive in our minds. As we share these meals, we remember our sibling in faith who came to this table decades and centuries past, and those who will surround this table in the future. We pray for all our church members, those that are near and far, maybe they are sick at home or in the hospitals. We remember Ethel Patterson, Lloyd Robinson, and Maria Vulture, Will and Maggie Patterson, Reverend Julie Savo, Katie Usher and family, Ron Brown, and the family of our minister, Reverend Adekunle Adeniyi. Let your Holy Spirit brood upon us today and forevermore. Amen. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 23 to 25 says, "For I received from the Lord what I also pass unto you. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same way, after supper, he took cup, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me.'" Let's say the words together. Celebrating new life, new hope, new vitality, and the spirit of resurrections in our life. Let us partake in this celebratory meal together. And as we sing, I will invite us, if you are prepared to receive communion this morning, those at the gallery will first come down. You pass by my left and by my right, and you go back through the center. They will serve you at the front. You take the bread, you take the wine, you drop your cup and go back and go and pray. Ask God to fill you. So, the body of Jesus given for you. The blood of Jesus given for you. Let us sing One Bread, One Body, number 467, as we come forward to receive the communion. I will encourage those at the gallery to please come down first and receive your communion first, then followed by those sitting in the gallery, sitting under the gallery in the church space here. Brethren, let us take the prayer of thanksgiving together. Dear God, you fed the multitudes and provided the manna in the wilderness. We give great thanks for the meal eating and the company surrounding us. Inspire us as we move forward this day and encourage us to transform our dreams into reality. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, forever and ever. Amen. Our closing hymn this morning is taken from More Voices, another book, this one, number 79, Spirit Open My Heart. Everyone here to our Bible study, everywhere is there. If you are walking, if you are not walking, between 1 to 2, and if you are walking, between 6 and 7. And on that day also, I want to welcome all our youth, for youth with a purpose, 6 to 7. And don't forget, I want to mark your calendar, like next week, by the grace of God, is going to be hymn singing. And in the afternoon, 4:30, we are gathering for potluck, and by 5, it is praise, dance, and word of God, 5 to 6 also. So I want you to mark your calendar, and I pray that we'll all be visited with the grace of God. Amen. Let us take the commissioning and benediction together this morning. Go in faith to be salt for the earth and light for the world, in Jesus' name. May God's love restore you. May Christ's teachings inspire you. May the Holy Spirit equip you to serve in a world that is ready to receive you, blessed by God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
That is too low. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you very much. And our choral benediction is Go in Peace.